It's such a tricky one because, like, you go, oh, okay, a person wants to use me as advertising. So then you're like, who is this person? And you want to make sure they're a real thing. And then, yeah.
How many subs did you have on that?
Oh, interesting. I had 40,000. And I had been, yeah, I've been doing a video every single week that year, and this was at the very end of the year. It was like you know when you play a video game and you're like, I have achievement unlocked, I have a spawn. And I was very proud, and I bought myself some Valentino, which I'm wearing today, the perfume.
Oh right, yeah. Cool.
It was like a well done you, you've got this now. and then, yeah, what was the next part of the question?
Do you like working with brands?
Love it, mate. It's great. Well, it's yes, I do. In short. But it can depend on the brand. I've been really lucky to get brands and, you know, companies that work with brands that understand what we do and understand, you know, how to work with us new people, new media folk. So I like it very much, but I have heard horror stories.
I've had quite an interesting time with sponsored videos because I feel like the ones that I've done I've really enjoyed. But I find that most of the time I'm just deleting emails going, no, no, that isn't quite right, that isn't quite right. So I think finding the right ones has been the most difficult part, but when it's right and it's really fun. And the other thing is because I mostly make videos about books, it's not very common at the moment for publishing companies or people working with books to sponsor YouTube videos. So that's quite rare to come by. And I'm really finding that it is mostly book-to-movie adaptations where it's then the film companies that work a lot with YouTubers, so I'm actually doing a lot more of that than book stuff. And it is, when you have a niche channel, it is quite interesting because I think a lot of brands will go, oh no, that's books, so that doesn't apply to us, so then sort of move on. And I think it's really fun when brands do go, oh, actually, maybe we can, you know, have a different twist to it, and because I talk about different stuff as well, so I think at the moment I'm trying to do sort of show, you know, on the front page of your channel, sort of trying to show what you do. I'm trying to show the variety of it, so when people, like, casually click by, they can kind of see that there's different stuff on there.
The channel is basically owned by a guy called Yanni, who has made the company name Yanimize. The main kind of money he makes is from actually wrapping cars for customers and just putting those videos on YouTube. So he's the personality on the channel. And recently we were contacted by Disney for him to do a voice part in the UK release of Cars 3.
Oh, that's so cool.
That's pretty good.
So yeah, that's going to be pretty hard to top, and that included doing about 7 or 8 videos. We over-delivered. I think they came to us originally wanting 6. We've done a lot more than 6, and it included him going to Vegas as well on a road trip. And yeah.
Oh, was that the one with Maya Jammer and doing, yes, and Ollie White? Saw that. Looked really, yes, good.
One of them was for the Far From the Madding Crowd film. That actually wasn't a paid collaboration, but they sort of arranged the trip. And I got to go with a friend and go visit the locations from the film, and it was such a fun weekend. And the video that I made out of it was probably one of my favorite videos I've ever made. So it was such a nice experience, even though it wasn't sort of a paid-for collaboration. And then I recently also did a video with Great Western, and we sort of went to Exeter. Again, they sort of sponsored that, but also provided train tickets. And it was really fun in the fact that it was quite, they were just like, you know, go take the train, read on the train, go do something fun. I'm like, that I'm on board with. That's great. So I also work for Penguin, and I arrange, like, YouTuber brand deals, I guess, for Penguin. So I've worked with Dan a lot with that as well.
I don't know, mainly because they, more than any, really sort of challenged me to think. And it's tricky because when you get a, you know, you're doing a sponsored video, you know, there can be an element of lethargy with audiences are getting so many ads, and you're just like, I need to almost work harder than I would on a regular video to make it so that this is worth your click. And for me, with something like Penguin, it's a chance to really think, actually, rather than just, hey, here's a list of books I like, okay, I'm going to curate a list of books and I'm going to talk about why I like them. I did one on horror where I got to talk about, you know, why we continue to seek out horror and scare ourselves. And that was a really fun thing to talk about recently. I did one about news and books you could read instead of the news to really widen your, you know, view of the world. So yes, stuff that challenges me is the stuff I enjoy most. That's my answer.
Cool.
You never know how to end these answers. You just trail off into the...
For me, the most important thing is having creative control. and being able to make something that actually fits on my channel. And I see myself as a creator, not an influencer. I'm not a billboard for you to put your advert on. Like, I'm a creator, which I hope everyone on here sees themselves as, especially if you're the brains and the brains behind your channel. So any that companies come to me without saying, oh, hey, do a daily vlog, and I have to go, I don't make daily vlogs. Have you seen a video that I've made? Like, anyone where I don't have to do that always ends up better. I like it more, my audience likes it more, and it keeps that relationship of being really, it feels authentic.
I have been offered good money to do something to advertise a video game. I don't play mobile video games, so what? And everyone would know that. So, like, you turn it down, and then you take one that is less money, but something that is more relevant than that you think your subscribers would actually get a kick out of, and they're like, you sell out, and you're like, oh,
I'm trying so hard.
It's good having a full sofa to be dramatic.